Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name's Pat Maney. I'm just another broken soldier, and I want to thank the Navy League for sponsoring this event. This is a huge step forward for those of us who have experienced traumatic brain injury. I was a general, a reserve general who was mobilized and deployed to Afghanistan. I was there for 17 months. I got blown up, as they said. My bell was rung on August 21st, 2005. I spent almost the next 20 months at Walter Reed Army Medical Center. You know, under the Army regulations, you can only be broken for a year, and then they kick you out. So I had been there about a year when a friend of mine suggested I try hyperbaric oxygen. Now, when I tell you I'm broken, let me take just a moment to kind of describe that. I was awake. I could walk. I could talk with some hesitation. But I basically looked okay. The problem, of course, is the brain is inside the head and not outside. Or maybe that's a good thing, but that's the way we're built. And my wife literally led me around everywhere I went. I couldn't remember how to go places, what I was supposed to do when I got there. I couldn't carry on conversations. There were these long, pregnant pauses while I tried to find words. One time she took me, always leading me, to the commissary. And you know how you get to the end of the aisle and turn and go down another aisle? She turned and I didn't see her turn, and I was lost. I literally stood there because I couldn't figure out how to solve that problem and go somewhere else. One time I was at the Bethesda Naval Hospital gas station, pulled up, got out of the car, opened the gas cap, put the nozzle in, and had no idea how to pump gas from a self-service pump. I was in uniform, so you can imagine the surprise of the lady on the other side of the pump when I asked her how to turn on the gas pump. But that's what a brain injury does. You can look all right. You can kind of function. You can walk and talk, maybe. But you're not there. And hyperbaric oxygen has totally turned that around for me. A doctor friend suggested it. I received treatment at George Washington Medical Center here in Washington. And, you know, what Admiral Fanning didn't say is in civilian life, I have a job as a judge. I'm an elected judge. And I knew that I was not only losing my Army career, but I was going to lose my civilian career because I couldn't function. So hyperbaric allowed me to go back to work. And I kind of, because of my personal experience, I saw and was able to recognize litigants and defendants who came before me who had traumatic brain injury. And I started looking into our jail population. Over 10% of the county jail in the county where I live are veterans. And I noticed that many of those had traumatic brain injury from, not just from this war, we had one that had been shot in the head in Panama. And of course, at the time of the Noriega, the time we removed Noriega in Panama in 1989, there wasn't a diagnosis for traumatic brain injury. I say that only because we've got many, many, many people in our society with traumatic brain injury. Many soldiers, even from this war, who are not diagnosed. And it just seems to me very important for all of us to try to join this coalition for hyperbaric oxygen. When I had hyperbaric, it's cumulative, you know. You don't notice any difference after any one treatment. Yeah, you get up and you leave. But the cumulative effect is amazing. After about 8 dives, 8 treatments, my wife thought she noticed I was getting better, but she didn't say anything because she wanted me to get better and she was afraid she was seeing something because she wanted it, not because it was real. After about 12 dives, I started thinking I was getting better, but I didn't say anything because I didn't want to raise my wife's hope. After about 20 dives, people who knew me before the injury and people who knew me after the injury started saying, "You look better. You're more engaged. You're talking in sentences and paragraphs." And that was a major difference. I've always been a reader. I couldn't read a paragraph and know what the first sentence was by the time I got to the last sentence. I couldn't balance a checkbook. I could write a check, but I had no idea what the numbers were, how to do simple subtraction. I couldn't concentrate long enough to watch a television show, so I would channel surf all the time. Drove my wife crazy. I couldn't sleep, so I was up at 2 or 3 in the morning. That also drove my wife crazy. So I guess part of that story is hyperbaric oxygen made my wife's life much better. And I think it's important, and I think some of the people here on this panel will tell you that a lot of these situations have two sides. The patient's side with its frustrations, and the caregiver's side with its frustrations. And when hyperbaric oxygen does its magic, the frustrations go back to normal and diminish. So thank you for coming, and thanks to the Navy League for having this. And I hope everybody will consider learning more about hyperbaric and joining this really crusade, this critical crusade to take care of America's wounded warriors.